How's it going, everyone? And welcome to the second VTV show of the year. I'm your host, Aiden Kozel, and today's show is all about homecoming. We're gonna tell you all the ways you can get involved in these super fun activities. And it's all coming right after this intro. The school hasn't had homecoming in nearly 2 years, so the student government is making sure this one will be remembered. Everybody knows that homecoming is a battle between the classes and who has the most spirit. Let's send it over to Kennedy Hardy and see what she has to say about this.
This year's homecoming week is being promised something new, different, and a whole lot of fun. The student government has been working hard to make this year's week more interactive for all students and spice it up with a little competition too.
All week long, you'll have the chance to help your graduating class earn points. At the end of the week, we count up the points and name the winning class, who will be crowned the most spirited class of homecoming. And as a prize for the winning class, you'll receive free admission to the homecoming football game Friday night. Yes, I said free, just for having fun all week and participating in the activities.
There'll be all kinds of ways to earn points for your class. And as always, we'll have dress-up days. Each day of the week, we'll assign a theme and you'll dress up according to that theme. Get crazy and have some fun with it.
You can also earn points for your class by attending home sporting events the week of homecoming. Go out and support your fellow students as they play the sport, and make sure you check in at the ticket booth to be counted as a crowd member for your class.
Of course, we'll have crazy competitions that can earn you points too. We'll have games and contests that'll be open to all grades. The more you win, the more points you earn for your class.
We're hoping this homecoming will be something to remember, and it's only fun if you participate. So listen up the rest of the show to hear how you can win.
We spoke earlier about competing in games. It's all new this year, and Ella and Ali have all the info for you.
Thanks, Sidalee and Kennedy, and they're right. The contests this year are new and will take skill and athleticism to win. And in order to participate, listen up and we'll tell you everything that you need to know.
We always have some big games in our pep assembly that everyone gets to see, and we will again this year. However, in order to compete at the pep assembly, you have to win the right to represent your class. And that happens at prelim night.
That's right. One night where you compete against the members of your own class in order to come out victorious and be the one who represents your entire class at the assembly. This takes place next Wednesday, September 1st, in the parking lot right outside E building. If you want to compete against the other classes, you first have to beat your own. So come out that night and earn your right to represent your class.
What are the competitions and how do you sign up? Easy. In your Google Classroom, you've been sent a form which lists all of the games and allows you to sign up for a chance to play. You gotta pick just one game, so look through them and see which contest fits you the best and sign up for it. We're also looking for teams or small groups to compete in the games, so get your friends together and see how dominant you can be.
Again, go to your Google Classroom and look for the message from Mr. Soselski. It has the link to follow to get signed up. And get this, your class will get points if you come out to participate. That's right. Even if you don't win your game, just being there can still help your class win the title. So the more the merrier.
All right, let's take a quick look at the games you can compete in.
Partner up for a team of one boy and one girl and see how far you can throw a football. Best combined distance wins.
Got a group of 10 strong people who can pull a rope? Then the tug of war is for you. 5 girls and 5 boys team up for this one to see who's the strongest.
TikTok is next. We provide the song and you get together a group of 4 to put on the best dance performance. Best show wins.
If you want a real battle, the egghead is for you. We put an egg on you and your opponent's head. First person to smash the other person's egg with a pool noodle wins. This one will be fun.
Big eaters are wanted for this next one. Whoever can eat a 12-pack of White Castle's burgers the fastest takes home the prize.
There's 5 fun ways you can compete and help your class win the Spirit Trophy. So get signed up and come out next Wednesday to help your class be the most spirited class of homecoming.
And keep listening to VTV and checking your Google Classroom announcements page for more fun ways to participate in homecoming 2021. And remember, we need you to participate to make this the best one yet.
Now that looks like a fun week. If you want to get involved, make sure you're checking your Google Classroom announcements page for a way to sign up and help your class win this battle. This year, the traditional girls powder puff game takes on a whole new meaning as you get to score points for your class. And guess what, underclassmen? You are getting the chance to participate. That's right. Nico and Preston have more.
Many people forget there's actually two popular football games that happen during homecoming. The boys play Friday night against Lincolnway Central, and we can't wait for that. But don't forget about the girls. They play Wednesday night on the ever-so-popular Powder Puff game. Watch as this year all four grades compete for the title of Powder Puff champions. That's right, freshmen and sophomores have been thrown into the competition to see if they can compete with the upperclassmen. There will be two semifinal games. The first will feature the senior class going up against the freshmen. Many think this will be a lopsided game.
No way freshmen is beating seniors. We got this, and freshmen are going down.
Imagine being a senior, like the freshmen are going to win this game. They're going to get the dub, you know, and yeah, the seniors are going to like lose, and the freshmen are going to win.
In the other semifinal, the junior class goes up against the sophomores for a chance to make it to the finals.
These sophomores are going down.
The sophomores are going to win. The juniors don't even have a chance.
The two winners will face each other for the championship and a chance to earn their class the top points in the spirit competition. Signups for girls will continue until the 40-girl roster is filled up. Go to the Google Classroom announcements page and look for the announcement talking about Powder Puff. Get ready to represent your class on the gridiron. Who will win in Powder Puff during the week of Homecoming 2021?
Get involved, girls. You can sign up at the campus store or simply go to your Google Classroom announcements page. The homecoming dance always caps off the week. And for the first time in 2 years, we are finally gonna have an in-person dance. Leah Rindeck and Langston Fantroy have more information. Let's check it out.
What is the big week of homecoming? The dance, of course. I'm gonna tell you everything you need to know about attending the dance.
The masquerade themed dance itself will take place Saturday, September 11th from 7:30 to 11 p.m. right here on our own football field.
It's a great chance for you to dress in your fittest clothes and either come with a date or with a group of friends. The dance will feature a live DJ playing the hottest tunes in an area to socialize and take your own pictures with your friends. Tickets have already gone on sale in the campus store for $20. Remember, if you want to bring someone who doesn't go to this school, you will need to fill out a guest form. That form can be found in the campus store as well. And you will need that form in order to buy a ticket for your guests.
It's been a long time since we were able to get together for a dance. I hope you're looking forward to it. Dance the night away and get your tickets today.
Okay, so now that we know what's going on with the homecoming dance, what's going on with the homecoming court? There's been some changes to this year's homecoming court and royalty, but as always, BTV has the scoop. Let's check it out.
Homecoming just wouldn't be complete if we didn't crown some homecoming royalty. That's why this year we've changed things up just a bit to make it more inclusive for all students. We'll once again crown two seniors as homecoming royalty this year. The nominations will be voted upon the week of homecoming. We'll also have a homecoming court, which consists of all underclassmen, freshmen through juniors. On Wednesday of next week, you've already heard about the preliminary games taking place in the parking lot of E Building. Well, that's where the nominations for homecoming royalty will be taken. That's right, there's no nominations by computer this year. It will be done in person. So, if you want to be part of the homecoming royalty court, you must come to the preliminary games and nominate yourself. You will also be asked to speak on camera and introduce yourself to the entire school. Once the nominations are in, the school will vote on who will be the next senior and underclass homecoming royalty at HF. We'll make the announcement of homecoming royalty on VTV the week of homecoming. So just to summarize, if you want to be part of homecoming royalty, you must come to the preliminary games from 6 to 8 p.m. And don't forget, speaking on camera is part of the requirements. Anyone is eligible, so if it's always been your dream to be homecoming royalty, don't forget to attend this one-time nomination event. It's from 6 to 8 on the E-Building parking lot, September 1st. Can't wait to see who will grace the dance this year at homecoming.
Okay, so it sounds like it will be a great homecoming, and getting involved is as easy as checking your Google Classroom announcements page and setting the date of September 1st as the day to compete for your class. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have for today's BTV show. I'm your host, Aiden Kozel, and we will see you tomorrow on the next edition of the Friday BTV show. Have a great day, HF.